Over that article in Gibbs magazine.
Did you read it?
No, what did it say?
Plenty. Of course, he didn't mention her name. He never does, but he might just as well have. Here, page 12. And if that door opens, ditch it for the love of Pete.
Don't worry, I'd sooner have the FBI catch me with the plans of the B-19 bomber.
Madame Gloria's office. Oh, I'm sorry, Miss Williams, but the madam won't be able to make that today. Yes, I'll call you later. Goodbye.
Boy, no wonder she's raving.
Wouldn't you think they'd get tired of battling each other after all these years?
Isn't that silly? What started it anyway?
Well, as far as I can find out, it started on their honeymoon, when Gibbs tried to make her live like he does, on fruits, vegetables, and nuts.
Gibbs and Madame Gloria? I didn't know they were ever married.
Well, it didn't last very long. She stood it about 6 months and then gave him up for a big juicy steak.
You've been trying to prove each other wrong ever since, huh?
Yes, and getting rich doing it. Let's see how the blitzkrieg is going.
What do you suppose I pay you $15,000 a year for, if it isn't to take care of things like this?
But, madam, I can't control...
Don't alibi! You get hold of his publicity man and make him lay off me and my business, or I'll...
Poor old Bolger.
I guess this is no time to ask for a raise. Call me when she cools off.
Don't worry. Oh, hello, Pat, I...
Hello, looks like you had a good workout.
She's not so hard to handle if you use the right approach. Excuse me, I'll see you later.
Where in the world have you been?
Oh, but Madame Gloria's, why?
Oh, nothing, except Gibbs's office has called here every 5 minutes for the last 2 hours, and I've just about run out of alibis.
Well, sorry, I ran into a small-sized tornado.
How much longer do you think you're going to get away with this, anyway?
I don't know, but it's fun while it lasts.
Sooner or later, one of them is going to find out that you're working for both of them. Then where will you be?
Looking for new clients, I guess. Get Gibbs on the phone and tell him I'm on my way.
Hey.
Yes?
Better take that copy of Gloria's magazine out of your pocket, stupid.
Uh-oh.
During the entire 62 years of my life...
In last month's articles, you said you were 58.
During the entire 58 years of my life, I have lived exclusively on vegetables, fruits, and nuts. I owe my vigorous health to this strict diet, which I have made the basis of the famous Gibbs system.
woman and man in America.
Sounds like a swell job.
It's not only a job, my boy, it's a career.
Same.
But getting back to Earth, you better get the place straightened out. Wait a minute. What's the idea? Why, Pat, what are you doing here?
What are you doing here?
Oh, just acting as one of the judges.
Not bad, Uncle. Who is she?
I haven't the slightest idea.
That's a pity. Oh, I'm sorry to be late, H.G., but you should have phoned me sooner.
Why,
So you haven't the slightest idea who she is, eh?
This is Miss Pat Hilton. I seem to have mislaid her measurements. I don't find her photographs either. Why, no. We don't seem to have anything on her.
She seems to have something on you, Uncle.
Yes. How you got in, eh?
Yeah, mine was an inside job. How did you do it?
No pictures, no measurements, no phone number. My, how distressing.
Yes, isn't it? That'll do, Miss Bolger. I mean, Miss Hilton. Thank you. All right, Bolger, let's see the next one.
$35.50 and 10 is 65 cents.
Well, that's 70, isn't it, Pedro?
Oh, well, I'll not charge you for the warm-up.
Well, tell Pat I've gone to Bulger's office at 5. I may be a little late getting back.
Okay, I'll tell her. Of course, I said, well.
You having a little trouble?
Hey, my hair in troubles. I don't know what's the matter with this toaster machine. A whole lot of bread I put inside, and it don't come out either. Maybe you better hex him, I think so.
Yeah.
¿Qué pasa? Cuidado.
Mixing gags, a lot of hooey. There's nothing to it.
I don't care whether there is or not. It ties into something else I'm working on. All we have to do is to play it up big. We'll call him the Miracle Kid. Get him a couple of fights, and every time he wins, the newspapers will eat up the story. That's all I want.
But suppose he don't win. He's no Dempsey, you know.
That's your job, to make sure he always wins.
That's gonna cost money.
Don't worry about that. The party I'm with.
When do we start?
Well, first I have to get the kid signed up, and I'm having a little trouble there.
Why?
On account of his girl. She don't want him to fight anymore. I may have to break up a romance before I get done.
Go right in, Hexie.
Thanks.
He isn't going to fight anymore. I don't think.
That's why he goes to the man's office, no?
I wonder.
That'll be her. Hello? Oh, hello, Pat.
Hey, what's all this about you wanting Jimmy to fight some more?
Oh, didn't he tell you? Yes, we've got him all set for 5 or 6 fights at $2,000 a fight. Isn't that great?
Put him on the phone.
Oh, he isn't here now. He and Helen Gibbs went out to celebrate his new contract. Mm-hmm. Hmm? Oh, I don't know. Said something about the Coast Highway.
Yes, the barnyard.
Is Pedro right? Is he going to give it to you as surprises?
Oh, no. I'm going to give it to him as surprises.
I wonder why I don't keep in my big mouth shut.
Would you mind coming in with me for a minute, Jimmy? I don't like to go in alone.
Well, all right.
Telephone.
Well, saved by the phone bell.
This is Jimmy Connley. Phone.
Well, who in the world?
Go ahead.
Mr. Jimmy Connley.
It's me.
Second booth, sir.
Thank you.
Hello?
Oh, hello, Pat. I'm sorry I couldn't make it at 6. Did Bulger tell you?
Yes, Bulger told me. But what are you doing out there?
Oh, nothing much. Just sitting around, having a couple of drinks. 3 or 4 of us.
3 or 4 of you, huh? Well, if you're going to rumble with that Gibbs girl, you better lay off those zombies. think little Pat is sitting home alone. You're crazy. Well, fancy meeting me here.
It is funny.
Funny as a call for help.
Well, I'm glad to see you.
I'll bet you are. You better run along and take care of your glowy little girlfriend.
Wait a minute. You don't understand.
Oh, no?
No, now listen to me. I'm going to tell you
You
that...
let go of me.
Don't be silly.
If you don't let go of me, I'll...
You'll what? Come here.
You let go of me.
Mateo was fighting Jimmy Friday night.
Oh, that's so?
Yeah. How would you girls like me to slip you a couple of passes? And after the fight, we'll go places.
You've got something there. What do you say, Pat?
Oh, I don't know.
Why, Pat? Nice to see you back.
Thank you. Mr. Gibbs said you wanted to see me about photographs.
Yes, I know. If you don't mind waiting a few minutes, I'll be right with you.
Not at all.
Come on in, boys.
Al is still handling Jimmy, isn't he? Mm,
yeah, sure.
And what are Kane and his manager doing here?
Oh, well, Mr. Kane is one of our accounts.
Oh, Al must be branching out.
I'll say he is. This is getting to be one of the busiest offices in town. Well, I never get a chance to go out for lunch anymore. How about it? Have some?
Oh, no, thanks.
Here's a 2,000.
Look, Bulger, I figure we got more to lose in this fight than you have. 2,000 ain't enough. We want 2,500.
Wait a minute. I thought Shady said that was agreed on. What is this, a holdup?
What do you mean?
Sit down. You don't mean nothing personal. This is business. You see the position we're in, don't you?
Yes, but 2,500 is a lot of money. Look, let's talk this over.
Nothing doing. Either it's a deal right now or it ain't. Well, what do you say?
Well, we'll find out.
Yes?
Get me the old lady. Tell her it's important.
All right.
She's the boss. If it's all right with her, it's all right with me. But I still think it's too much.
Hello, Marge? Mr. Bulger wants to speak to Madam. It's very important. Okay, I'll hang on.
May I borrow your pencil, please? Oh, I'm so sorry. Oh, well, I think if you sponge it with cold water right away.
Not fooling.
I thought you knew how to manage these setups. For two pins, I'd call the whole thing off.
Oh, I wouldn't do that now. The fight's all arranged. The publicity's out. It'd be a terrible kickback if it turned out wrong and Jimmy lost. We'd be the laughing stock of the town. To say nothing of what it would do to your business.
Oh, all right, give it to him. If there are any more slip-ups like this, I'll get somebody else to handle these deals.
I thought you were out of town.
I just got back this morning.
Oh.
Jimmy, I found out something that you should know. There's some place around here we can talk?
Well, sure. In the office.
No cauliflower here?
You always did worry about them, didn't you?
I used to, but not anymore.
Well, how am I doing? 5 knockouts in a row and a 6 coming up.
You're pretty sure of yourself, aren't you?
Yep, me and the old Hex and these.
The old Hex. Don't tell me you really believe that stuff, Jimmy.
Well, it's already worked 5 times. None of the fights over 4 rounds.
Listen, those fights were won in somebody's office before you ever stepped into the ring.
What are you talking about?
Oh, you poor kid. Don't you know you're being used by Bulger? All those knockouts were framed.
Oh, now I'll tell one.
Look, you're fighting Kane on Friday, aren't you?
Yep, and he won't go 4 rounds.
I know he won't. I just came from Bulger's office, and Kane and his manager were there. I heard Bulger tell Madame Glory over the phone that Kane wanted $2,500 to lay down in the 4th round. And she said, okay. You don't believe me, do you?
No, I don't.
Okay, Mr. Big Shot.
I was trying to help you, but I guess it's no use. But along about the third round Friday night, you act groggy and start to fall. You see if Kane doesn't hold you up. I just made a fool of myself. I should have known better. Not worth it anyway.
Well, senorita, that is the mouth who is talking, not the heart. And you don't fool old Pedro. Yeah, yeah, go ahead. Try to looking mad. You is funny, you two kids. Very funny. First Jimmy coming in with his chin down to here and mad with you. Then you coming in and mad with him. It's very funny, you two kids. Very funny.
Oh, what's funny about it?
It's funny because why? It's so silly, that's why. Wait, I'm going to show you something. Here, look at this.
What is it?
It's the farm, that's what is it. You sell it, Jimmy find out, he buy it and give it back to you. What do you think of that? And besides this, Jimmy give it to me money every week to take care of for him. $700-$800 he's got already. And you say Jimmy's no good? You're crazy, you are crazy.
I guess I am crazy.
Oh, muchacha mia, excuse me. I don't got the right to score you like this. But I wish I had the right to spank you, you crazy little kid.
Yeah, I've got a crazy idea, too. There's only one way to wake Jimmy up.
What's that?
To have K.O. Kane knock him out.
What are you going to do?
Oh, I've got one fighter on my hands already. Now I'm going to buy the other one. This fight's going to end my way. Now, for reasons of my own, which wouldn't interest you, I want Jimmy Connolly knocked out tonight. Well, of course, I know it would, shall we say, upset your plans.
What plans?
Yours and Bolger's. I could go to the boxing commission. Oh, I know it might be a little difficult to prove anything. Besides, if I did, it'd be a black mark against Jimmy. So I'm willing to match Bolger's $2,500 if you can knock him out.
What do you mean, if I can knock him out?
Oh, all right. If you will knock him out.
That's better.
Don't put him away too soon.
Don't worry. I won't.
And then he says that I break my right hand. How do y'all like that?
The kid ain't wise, I guess. So much the better, but he don't know when to hide him.
Tickets, please.
Oh, I want to see Kane's manager.
Well, I'm sorry. You have to wait till the fight's over. Let's see your tickets. They're over there, two aisles over. You have to go all the way around.
Well, I must get a message to Mr. Rocco. It's very important.
Well, I'm sorry.
Look. You just slip up to him and tell him Pat Hilton's here and everything's okay. Now, remember the name, Pat Hilton.
All right, you get your seats and I'll find you if there's any answer.
Thanks. Come on, Pedro.
All right.
Hello, Commissioner.
Hello, Rocco. How's it going?
We're fighting a pretty tough boy tonight.
Kane ought to be able to take care of him, all right?
I don't know.
This is it.
Oh, good seats, no?
Excuse me. Gentlemen.
Rocco. Pat Hilton's here and says everything's okay.
Pat Hilton?
Yeah.
Never heard of him. What do you mean, bother me at a time like this? You want to get fired?
No, sir.
Well, then, Peter, get out of here. Come on.
Did you tell him?
He said he never heard of you.
He never heard of me?
Yeah.
Well, listen, he certainly did have... Well, how do you like that?
Listen, you come with Pedro. He take you.
Sit down. I think I've already been taken.
Huh?
Skip it.
That Hilton gal get here yet?
Yeah.
But the 500?
Forget it. You're still losing the floor.
Here's hoping he tries it.
Huh?
Nothing.
going to be a fight?
Yeah, it's going to be a dive, but you're going to take it.
Come on, Jimmy. Attaboy, Jimmy, attaboy.
Come on, Kane.
Attaboy, Jimmy, attaboy.
What am I yelling for?
Like a cold winter ahead of you, my dear.
Well, mastermind, let's see you talk your way out of this one.
Now, now, let's not get excited.
Not get excited.
boxes go right over there under the tree.
That's right.
Right there.
You was too big for Chiquita's baby anyway, Jimmy.